In this video, we're looking at the work energy theorem applied to a braking car. So we're given this car with a mass of 1200 kilograms, initial speed of 26.5 meters per second, and it applies the brakes and slows down to 14.6 meters per second over a given distance of 45.0 meters. In the first part of the problem, we're asked to compute the work done by static friction acting on the car. And this can be a bit of a tricky concept to realize that what we're looking at is static friction exerted on the car. First, that means we have to understand the car is slowing down because the road is exerting a force on the tires, and that force points to the left. And second, even though everything is moving here, this is a static friction force. It would only be a kinetic friction force if the tires were actually slipping against the concrete. But we're told these tires are not actually slipping. This is just an ordinary braking process. So to get the work done by this static friction force, we're going to use the work energy theorem. And that says the total work done on this car during this process results in a change in kinetic energy. So the work is equal to delta K, and that delta always means final minus initial. So I have my final kinetic energy minus the initial kinetic energy. So we just plug in our final and initial kinetic energies. So that's 1/2 mv2 squared, that was our final speed, minus 1/2 mv1 squared. And we can factor the 1/2 m out of this just to clean it up a little before we plug numbers in. So I get 1/2 m times the quantity v2 squared minus v1 squared. So now we can sub our numbers into this, and the mass of the car was 1200 kilograms. The final speed, 14.6 meters per second. The initial speed, 26.5 meters per second. And you should notice even before plugging in the numbers that this is going to result in a negative amount of work. And that makes sense because friction is removing energy from the system. It just caused the kinetic energy to decrease. So that's a negative work. So to four significant digits this time, we end up with a work of negative 293,500 joules. Now, ordinarily, I round everything off to three significant digits, but we have to use this result to continue the calculation in part B. So I just wanted to keep a little extra precision. So in part B, we're asked for the magnitude of the static friction force. And we know how much work that force did now. That was negative 293,500 joules. So the work done by the static friction, I'll just call it WF sub S, is going to be equal to a negative number. So the way I'm going to write this is that it's the negative of the magnitude of the static friction force, Fs, multiplied by my displacement. So the way I set that up, I'm treating Fs as a positive number. That's just the size of the static friction force, and that's actually what we're looking for. So we sub in the known value of the work done by friction, negative 293,500 joules. That's negative Fs times the size of my displacement, in other words, the distance that this force acted through, and that was 45.0. And we can quickly solve for the magnitude of the static friction force. And rounding this off to three significant digits, I get 6,520 newtons. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.